Welcome to the HyperEdge Architecture in Action demo. The objectives of this demo are the following: showcase the HyperEdge building blocks, that is, mixed stacks and distributed services. In this demo, we will showcase advanced routing with BRF Lite, GRE, and MCT to scale out the HyperEdge architecture. We will show the alternatives in the core for this campus solution, that is, the ICX6650. The Fast Titan SX 800 and 1600, MLXC, and the ICX7750. For this demo, I built two mixed stacks, stacks A and B. Stack A consists of two ICX6610 and two ICX6450. Stack B consists of one ICX6610 and one ICX6450. I am running VRF Lite on each stack, and I have two video servers, one streaming a U.S. Navy video and the other one streaming a U.S. Air Force video. I also have a video client in Stack B. My core is only running Layer 2, so I created a GRE tunnel across the core to route VRF Lite between the two mixed stacks. The core was built with ICX6650s, but we can build a core with ICX7750, SX800 or 1600, or an MLXC. All support MCT. Remember this topology as we go through the demonstration. Follow me to the TME lab. Remember the topology. I have a mixed stack A with two ICX6610s stacked with two ICX6450 via 10 gig ports in the front. I have a 4-unit stack in this mixed stack. I have mixed stack B, one ICX6610 stacked with one ICX6450 via 10 gig ports in the front. This is a 2-unit mixed stack. At the bottom, I have my core, an MCT pair. Note that I have each mixed stack dual attached to the core. My MCT pair formed with two ICX6650s. I also created a management VLAN. Both of the mixed stacks as well as the core switches are part of that VLAN. Remember my two video servers from the topology drawing? My red server with US Air Force video has an IP address. And my blue server with the US Navy video also has an IP address. Actually, the same IP address. We have two virtual networks running over one physical infrastructure. This is VRF Lite. Two ships in the night, they don't see each other. My client PC also has its IP address already assigned. Now, we get the demo started by pulling a video stream from the video server. Notice that the US Air Force video comes up. That means that we have the client PC attached to the VLAN that belongs to the red VRF instance. Let's follow the cabling. Now let's move the connection to a blue VRF and see what happens. The video continues to run with the buffered packets, but then freezes, and a new video stream shows up, the US Navy video. The client PC is now receiving the video feed from the blue server. And why not? Let's switch it again. Let's move back to the red VRF and see if it works as expected. The same thing happens. Video freezes, and then the client PC picks up the red server video stream. This is a very simple demo to show the benefits of HyperEdge. In summary, the HyperEdge architecture brings more value to our customers than traditional competitors' stacks, even when they claim hardware mixed stack support. HyperEdge building blocks bring advanced features into lower-end switches in a hardware mixed stack. This is HyperEdge architecture in action. Hardware mixed stacks and distributed services. That is, advanced features with flexible topology deployments can be deployed at a lower cost, directly impacting our customers' bottom line. With MCT, we increase the scalability and high availability of HyperEdge architecture, and we have a few options in the core. ICX6650, SX800, and 1600, MLXE, and ICX7750. This is the HyperEdge architecture.